Just to go through this poem again, we have done this in detail, but I want that my dear students, they should find out the poetic device from this poem. So the very first line, when the humid shadows hover, can anybody tell me what is the device used here? I'll be appreciating that, child. Type in chat box. Hurry up, type in chat box. See, yes, very good. Only Jayati has written, correct. So, bachche, here you will come to know that humid hover. Humid hover. H and H has been repeated. This consonant has been repeated. You just go through the second line. Over all the starry spheres. Starry spheres. S and S has been repeated. So there is a repetition of H and S. There is a repetition of S and S. So which poetic device is that? Yes, it is alliteration. Write down the spellings of alliteration carefully. Whenever there is a repetition of any sound, any vowel, any consonant, then which poetic device is used? It is alliteration. Okay? Now all of you should have books in your hand. You just underline the examples of alliteration and type in chat box and tell me what do you think are the suitable example of alliteration. Hurry up. There are so many. There are abundance of examples of alliteration given in this poem. I have given you only two. I have told you only two, and I hope my dear students will be able to find out very easily. So find out the examples of alliteration. Hurry up. In first stanza, that is humid and hover. In second line, we have starry and sphere. After that, hurry up. Type in chat box. Very good, Aparan. Cottage chamber. Yes. Cottage chamber. C and C has been repeated. Another example. Type in chat box. Yes, very good. Yes, yes, hurry up. I'm reading from your chat box. Let me see how many students are attentive. Very few are writing. Yes, lie listening, very good. You just go step by step. go step by step. Yes, press pillow. Press pillow. Very good. Then Renuka has written darling dreamers. Yes, Renuka. Yes, darling dreamer. That is your correct answer. Divya, soft rain is not alliteration. Yes, Renuka. Yes, busy being. Busy being. B and B has been repeated. And in other example, other students also type. Hurry up. Yes, it is their thread. TNT. Yes, rain, roof. So underline all the examples of alliteration which is given in your book. Yes, memory, my mother. Yes, memory, my mother. So throughout the poem you can come across so many alliteration examples where consonant is being repeated again and again. Cottage, chamber, press, pillow, darling, dreamer, busy being, their thread, rain, roof, memory, my mother. So all these are very suitable and appropriate examples of alliteration. Clear, bachche? Shall I move further? Okay. Yes, Star is here. I have written, bachche, I think. No? Okay. In beginning, I have given you example of starry sphere. Yes, and S has been repeated. So all these are examples of alliteration. So the very first poetic device that is used in this poem is alliteration. Now shall I move further? Shall I move further? Only 4 or 5 students are typing in chat box. Others are not typing at all. Another poetic device we have is onomatopoeia. So what is the meaning of this? Can anybody tell me? Have you listened to this poetic device ever? Onomatopoeia? What is that? Hurry up, type in chat box. What is that onomatopoeia? Okay, you are doing it first time? Okay, in 9th class, yes. You are doing it first time, okay? So onomatopoeia is a word which suggests the meaning by its sound. Okay, it suggests the meaning by its sound. We have gone through this poem yesterday very carefully and we have come to know some words in the poem which describe the sound of a rain. Yes, there were some words which were describing the sound of the rain. So what was that? Hurry up, find out. What was that? Which word was describing the sound of the rain? Very good. So many students are typing in chat box. Aparan, Jayati, Sudiksha, all are writing very well. Yes, there was a word, patter. Because patter means to create sound. So this word was used in poem again and again. And this beautiful word was describing the sound of rain. Very good. another word, yes, one of the student is writing, yes, tinkle, tinkle also. So patter, tinkle, all these words, okay, are describing the, yes, there is another word also. What is that? I told you the meanings yesterday. I told you to write down in your books. I explained you the meaning. Patter word describes the sound of a rain. Tinkle word also describes the, yes, very good, Jayati. Yes, Jayati, your answer is right. It is shingle. So many students are participating in my class. That's really good. So shingles. So all these words are describing the sound of a rain. So these words are onomatopoeia. This poetic device is used because in this poetic device, by using the word patter, tinkle, shingles, the poet is telling us the sound of a rain, which kind of sound is being produced by rain. Sound is patter, sound is tinkle, sound is shingles. So onomatopoeia is related to sound. It is related to sound. Okay? It is related to audio. The sounds we listen. Okay? So in every stanza, patter word is used. Okay? Tinkle word is also used. Rain. Shingles word is also used. Okay. So whenever raindrops fall down, so whenever raindrops falls down on the shingles, so they create different kind of sounds to describe the beauty of the sound. Very beautiful words are used, patter, tinkle, and shingles. So this another poetic device we have, onomatopoeia. And in your exam also, examiner can ask you, give one example of onomatopoeia. Okay, but shingles is word is used to show the sound. Shingles means roof, but here shingles is used to show sound. Clear? Yes, I have told you the meaning of shingles yesterday. But I have told you the meaning of shingles, that was a roof, but here you can pick up two words which means proper sound, that is patter and tinkle. Clear? Yes, shingle means roof. So patter and tinkle, both two words are showing the sound of a rain. Okay? Now next poetic device that we have is next poetic device that we have is personification. Personification. Can anybody tell me the meaning of personification? Can anybody tell me the meaning of personification? Yes, type in chat box. Very good, Jayati. When human abilities to a non-living objects are given. Yes. When attributes of human are given to non-living things. See, when in the beginning, when we read only first stanza, so the darkness is described gloomy. See, we can feel gloomy, we can feel sad, we can feel happy. But do you think that the surrounding can be gloomy and sad? Yes, very good. Another example, the rain has typed in chat box. The tears of rain. When we cry, we have tears in our eyes. Do you think that the rain can be considered tears? It means rain is personified as a living human object, living thing. Yes. So when attributes are given to non-living things, like of Yes, very good. So when non-living things are given the attributes of living things, this come into the category of personification. And in this point, we have so many examples of personification. So let's find out. Hurry up. Find out personification first example. From the very first paragraph. Yes. Melancholy, darkness. Melancholy means sad. We can feel sad because we are human beings. But darkness, darkness is considered melancholy, sad. So here darkness is a non-living thing. Non-living. But attributes are given of living. So that's why it has become example of personification. It means darkness has been personified. What has been personified? What has been personified here? Darkness. Because what attribute, what adjective is added with darkness? Melancholy. So melancholy dark is added with darkness. So it has become as a human being. Another example, gently weeps the rain. When we feel sad, we are in pain, we cry, we have tears in our eyes. So do you think that rain can have a tears? So here rain has been personified. Yes, rain has been personified because rain has been taken as a human who is weeping, who is crying in the sad environment. So rain has been personified here. Clear, bachche? So melancholy, darkness, okay, so this. Now one of the student is having doubt. I'm going to take your doubts related to this poem. Let me start sharing the screen. Now, who is having a doubt? Okay, Divya is saying she is having a doubt in rhyme scheme. Okay, Divya, tell me in which paragraph you are having doubt. Okay, Divya is saying she is not able to understand the rhyme scheme. What is that? What is that? Okay, bachche, you have done rhyme scheme so many times. See, you have to pick up only the last word. You have to pick up the last word of the Wait, you have to pick up the last word. So last word is hover. Hover, spheres, darkness, tears, pillow, bed, patter, overhead. Now tell me which words are rhyming. Which words are rhyming? Sphere and tears, hover and darkness. Are they making any rhyme scheme? See, hover, it means it has A. Sphere, sphere is having B. Darkness, darkness is having C. And tears, tears is having again, yes, B. Because sphere and tears, both are making same sound. Okay? And after that, pillow. Pillow is having D. Bed is having E. Yes. Patter is having F. And bed and head making same sound. So its rhyme will be E. So what will be the rhyme scheme of first stanza? A B C B. Why A B C B? Because pear and tears have same sound. Bed and overhead have same sound, but pillow and petal are having different sounds. Now Divya, tell me, is this concept clear to you? Let me read from chat box. Divya, is it clear to you? Yes, bachche. Yes. Okay. So this was all about. We have discussed rhyme scheme yesterday also, but she was not able to understand. So that's why I have written here again. I've told her to how to find out rhyme scheme. Okay, welcome, beta. If this concept is clear, now I have told you three poetic devices also. Which poetic devices are used here? Personification is there, onomatopoeia is there, and there are abundance of examples of alliteration. Okay, so now let's move further. So yesterday we were able to do this point, but literary devices were not explained in detail. So bachche, now let's do question answers. What do the following phrases mean to you? Discuss in class. Humid shadows, I have told you yesterday, but now you have to tell me, what is the meaning of humid shadows? What is the meaning of humid shadows? Hurry up. You can type in chat box also. Very good. Yes, Sudiksha, very good. Humid shadows mean, yes, shadowy clouds which are full of rain water. Yes, clouds which are full of rain water. So this is your right answer. Very good, Aparan. Dark clay clouds full of moisture. That is also right line. These are dark gray clouds which are full of moisture, which are full of rain water, which are full of droplets of rain water. So all these answers are correct. Starry sphere. Starry sphere. Very simple. I think you all might know this thing. Starry sphere. Very good. Yes. Sky that is covered with bright stars. Yes. Stars in the sky. Very good, Renuka, Jayati, Aparan. All are typing correct answer. Others also type this. Yes, night sky with bright stars. Abundance of stars in the night sky. Very good. Now next is, what a bliss. Bliss means, I've told you yesterday the meaning of bliss. Bliss means utmost joy. Yes, utmost joy experienced by. Yes, utmost joy experienced by poet. Very good. Utmost joy experienced by poet. Very good. Next is, a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. Very good. Very nice. A thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start means various imaginative things, various imaginative thoughts, ideas, fantasies, yes, that are arousing in our mind. So a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start means different kind of imaginative ideas, thoughts, which are occurring in our mind, which are hovering in our mind, revolving in our mind. Clear? The next is, a thousand recollections weave their air thread into woof. Who is going to tell me the meaning of this line? I've explained you yesterday in detail. A thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof. A thousand recollections. Okay. Simran has written, numerous memories intermingle. to form a beautiful picture that the poet recollects. Very good. Because there were different kind of memories which were hovering in the mind of a poet, but it forms a very beautiful picture that the poet is able to recollect. Okay? Yes. So the memories which were going into the mind of a poet, it intermingle and it forms a very beautiful picture that the poet is able to recollect. So these answers you have to write down using only 2 to 3 lines. Now there is the next question that we are going to discuss. What does the poet like to do when it rains? Very simple, raise your hand for that. What does the poet like to do when it rains? Okay, Simran, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. When it rains, the poet feels very happy and delighted to lie with his head pressed against the pillow of his cottage chamber bed, and he listens to the patter of the soft rain. He is able to refresh all the old memories of his siblings lying down with him at night, and his mother looking at him with happiness and love in her eyes.
Very good. Perfectly elaborated. The answer was perfectly elaborated. Keep it up. Now, same answer I expect from Daljeet. Okay, Daljeet, you tell me, what do you think? What does the poet like to do when it rains? Yes, Daljeet, you tell me this answer. There are so many activities he loves to do. We have gone through this poem yesterday in detail. I explained to you. But if you're not able to give answer, that's really bad. Aryan Chopra, can you tell me? Aryan Chopra, can you tell me? See, there are so many activities he wants to press against the pillow of his bed. He wants to stay in his cottage. He wants to listen to the patter of soft rain which is falling on the tiles of the cottage roof. Yes. Okay. This answer, Aparan, where is she? Aparan, you just raise your hand. It will be easy for me to find out you. Yes, Aparan, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. The poet liked to press his hand into the pillow of his bedroom and listen to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Because of the soft sound of the rain, he is able to recollect his all the memories which he has made a collection of a beautiful picture in his past.
Okay, good. Very good. So it means the poet, when it is raining, the poet feels very much happy. Okay, he wants to keep his head against the pillow of his bed. He wants to stay in his cottage. He wants to take rest there. He wants to listen the, you can say, soothing sound of rain. He wants to enjoy the patter of soft rain. So he wants to stay inside. Now next question we have is the No, you have written, Divya has written, he remembers his mother. But the question is that, what does he want to do? These are the memories which are coming in his mind, but actually what does he want to do? Okay, now next question is, what is the single memory, major memory that comes to the mind? Yes, that is of his mother. Okay, who are the darling dreamers he refer to? The darling dreamers are his siblings, are his brothers and sisters. When they were all sleeping together by their mother, and mother used to look after them when they were sleeping so soundly. So when they were sleeping so soundly, mother was with them and she used to look after her babies. But now mother is no more. Her mother is no more. She is not with her, with him. So that's why he is recalling those sweet memories. Siblings means brother and sister. Bachche, siblings means brother and sister. Clear? So this answer I expect from Mitansh. Can you give me this answer? Mitansh.
Yes, ma'am. The major memory that comes in the poet's mind was that when the, his siblings, which he called the darling dreamers, came slept together, and the major memory was of his mother.
Only this much. Explain yes. In detail. Daljeet, your answer is ready or not? Daljeet.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me this answer.
Ma'am, please give me some hints.
Where were you?
Ma'am, I was in front.
Not listening to me earlier.
Ma'am, I don't know the answer.
That's really bad. Your performance is going down by down. Nowadays. You don't participate in my class. So who is going to tell me this? Okay, Dhiren, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. When the rain, rainy tears weeps inside the home and his rain patter comes on his home, the poet remembers a major memory that is of his kind mother, and the darling dreamers he refers is as to his siblings, and his, that is his her brothers and sisters. He used to sleep together with them at night, and her mother made them all sleep. And while they went to sleep, they were asleep, her mother used to look at them and feel good. And but now the poet is sad as he thinks that his mother is no more.
Good. Very good. Perfectly written. So next, so in this answer, you have to tell that major memory that comes back to the poet is the memory of his mother and her look. Okay? And the darling dreamers, these are the siblings, brother and sisters of his childhood. Then they were put to sleep together. They all were sleeping together by the side of their mother. And when they were fast asleep, their mother used to look after them. She used to, you can say, pat them with love. Now, is the poet now a child? Is his mother still alive? What do you think? Ridhima, you tell me. What do you think?
No, the poet is not a child anymore. His mother is no more, but her memories always haunt her, and his childhood always remain in his mind. And every single time when rain comes, he always remind of his childhood, and her mother talks.
Okay, very good. Now the poet is not a child. He is grown up. Okay? And he is remembering that precious moment of his life, that when he was a child, he used to sleep along with his brother and sister, and mother was also with them to look after them. He was sleeping in a cozy environment in the lap of his mother. Okay, and whenever it used to rain outside, he used to listen to the patter of that beautiful sound, which was made by soft rain. Okay, and in line, in one of the line, it is said that mother comes in his memories, okay, a years ago. So from that line, it is crystal clear that mother is now no more. She is not alive. Okay? Mother is no more. She is not alive. So, bachche, you are supposed to do these question answers in your prayer notebook. And tomorrow we will be doing writing skill. Okay? So you do your work daily, whatever is done. So you do these question answers in your prayer notebook. Now time is running out. I have to over this class. And today you get ready with your rough notebooks, because tomorrow I will be we will be doing writing skills, report writing and letter writing, both are left. So we will continue with that one. Okay, students. Now do the question answers of this poem in your prayer notebook. And still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Raise your hand if you have any doubt. Okay, students. Now, thank you and have a nice day.